In 2022, we reported on the problem of coal ash in our collaborative project, Poisonous Ponds. There have been some developments recently, so today we bring you an update.
The industrial history of the Great Lakes region was largely fueled by coal. Coal ash is a product of burning coal, and it's often stored in ponds surrounding coal-burning power plants. Coal ash contains mercury, cadmium, arsenic, and other heavy metals, which have been linked to cancer, heart disease, and thyroid disease. Out of more than 1,500 coal ash ponds, landfills, and dump sites spread across the U.S., the environmental group Earth Justice says there are 88 coal ash dump sites within 2 miles of one of the Great Lakes. Waukegan is a city of about 89,000 in Lake County, Illinois, about halfway between Milwaukee and Chicago. Dulcie Ortiz, a lifelong resident and community activist, is co-chair of Clean Power Lake County.
Waukegan has suffered from industrial pollution. We have 5 Superfund sites. So we've seen the horrors that these companies have done to our community.
Since 2013, Clean Power Lake County and the Sierra Club of Illinois have been battling with the owners of the massive power plant in Waukegan. The concern is over 2 coal ash ponds about 100 yards away from the Lake Michigan shoreline. They are the byproduct of burning coal at the plant currently owned and operated by NRG Energy. Christine Nannicelli is with the Sierra Club of Illinois.
Coal ash has been contaminating groundwater on the shores of Lake Michigan here for over a decade. Since 2010 was when we first saw groundwater monitoring show elevated levels of a variety of different pollutants.
Although the power plant in Waukegan no longer burns coal to generate electricity, the coal ash ponds remain, despite calls for their removal.
Constituents here in the community have been wanting that plant closed going back to the 70s.
In 2022, Illinois State Representative Rita Mayfield told us that NRG has resisted these calls, battling regulatory efforts in court and proposing a plan to remove the coal ash from one of the ponds, but cap the other pond and leave the coal ash in place.
So it's not that it can't be done, it's just that they choose not to do it. So they want to cap them in place, leave them there, and then let some future generation deal with it. We're saying no.
At that time, a spokesperson for NRG said in an email that the coal ash at the Waukegan site is having no impact on Lake Michigan or the beach, making removal unnecessary, adding that NRG monitors the groundwater around the ash ponds quarterly, as required by federal law, and that the ash ponds are not causing contamination, and points out that the groundwater in that area is not used for drinking water. But while NRG maintained there was no groundwater contamination at the Waukegan plant, the Sierra Club of Illinois said the opposite.
They are checking the water because we get those reports, and we see the ongoing groundwater contamination continuing at the same levels as we did originally in 2010.
We know that our community has suffered so much from industrial polluters that have just gotten their millions of dollars, left the community, left us with just toxic soil that really nothing can be done until it's remediated.
For years, there has been a stalemate between Waukegan residents and the power plant. But in April of 2024, the federal EPA issued 4 new regulations, one of which takes direct aim at the coal ash ponds. Attorney Gavin Carney is with the environmental group Earth Justice.
Now they have to do site-wide cleanup. That's the biggest win in the rule. If you look at the states that have lots of coal ash, it's Michigan, Indiana, Illinois, Ohio, Wisconsin to some extent, Pennsylvania. So this is a big issue for the Great Lakes.
The new EPA rules eliminate a loophole that Carney says the power industry has been using to avoid cleaning up the coal ash mess.
So one of the things that industry has been claiming is that when the rule said that they have to eliminate liquids from coal ash, meaning no water that can then leak out into groundwater, that when EPA said liquids, they didn't actually mean groundwater. They argued in legal papers specifically that that groundwater is not a liquid for purposes of the coal ash rule.
Illinois State Representative Rita Mayfield is cautiously optimistic.
Well, I'm glad that the U.S. EPA is understanding the hazards of this particular coal ash and that they are moving forward with demanding that these businesses be good corporate neighbors and clean up their mess.
In response to the new EPA rules, NRG said in a statement, "We have been and will continue to evaluate our plans with respect to the federal regulations published in May 2024. NRG maintains that capping the coal ash is the best option and said in the statement, the closure process will be quicker and less impactful to the environment than closure by removal. Frank Pettis, a community organizer with Clean Power Lake County, calls the new EPA rules just another beginning in their long battle with NRG.
They have an obligation to clean those up, and the failure to meet that obligation is likely to result in something very similar to one of, you know, another Superfund site. And we already have 5 of the 8 in Lake County. We don't need another one.
So we have to fight, and we have to continue to hold NRG and other corporate polluters responsible.
Meanwhile, the coal ash still sits in ponds scattered throughout the Great Lakes region. Under the new EPA rules, power plant companies have until 2028 to start removing the coal ash at their own expense.
They created the mess, they have to clean it up, they have to pay the dime for cleaning it up. One of the concerns that we have is that in states where utilities are allowed to pass on the cost to ratepayers, that some of these companies may actually try to make consumers responsible for the cost of cleanup, basically put it on your energy bill, the cost of taking care of their legacy of pollution.
Well, we want the coal ash removed from our shores, away from our water supply, and we want to have access to our lakefront for the first time in any of our lives.